Welcome everyone. In episode 2, we talked about the universe expanding rate, Hubble constant, of 20.66 km per second for each 1 million light year distance. This means that the time-space fabric located between planet Earth and up to a radius of 1 million light year is expanding, causing the galaxies at 1 million light-year distance to move away from Earth by a speed of 20.66 km per second. The same time-space fabric expansion will cause galaxies at 2 million light-year distance to move away from the Earth by 20.66 multiplied 2 equal 41.32 km per second, and so on. For every 1 million light year increase in distance, the galaxy's speed moving away from Earth increases by another 20.66 km per second. As the speed of light is 299,792.458 km per second, roughly 300,000 km per second. So with a simple calculation for a distance h, where h equal 300,000 divided by 20.66 multiply 10 to the power of 6 equal a distance of 14.5 billion light year. H is the distance where the time-space fabric expansion starts to cause galaxies beyond it to move away from Earth faster than the speed of light. It is called the Hubble sphere. What does that mean? And how the speed of light can be exceeded? To visualize the universe expansion, we need to see it as the space itself is expanding, not the galaxies are moving through it. If we have a balloon with dots on its surface, the inflation of the balloon causes the dots to move apart. The dots are not actually moving through the balloon surface. In fact, the expanding surface is taking them apart. As per the relativity theory from Albert Einstein, light speed is the ultimate speed anything can travel through the time-space fabric. The same theory has no restriction for space itself to expand faster than the speed of light. Where this is leading us to? When the galaxies move away from us faster than light, after the Hubble sphere, it means that we lose any contact with them. But due to the universe expansion, we are still able to receive light from galaxies just after the Hubble sphere, up to a radius of 16.75 billion light year. And this is called the present event horizon sphere. The event horizon is expanding till it reaches 17.5 billion light year, and that is the limit. No light can ever reach us after this distance, neither now nor in any time in the future. Whatever galaxy we see today after this point is only the past image of it, before the space expansion drifts it away beyond the event horizon. This is the limit of our vision at the present. If we compare our event horizon to the visible universe, it measures only 5% of it. The rest 95% we can no longer receive or send any information. It's a sphere we are trapped in forever. The next circle presents our vision limit in the past. It is called the particle horizon, or the visible universe, with radius of 46 billion light years. After that comes the whole universe beyond our vision, now and in the past. It is calculated, based on the Big Bang theory, to be at least 500 times bigger than our visible universe. This gives a radius of at least 23 trillion light years. We can see how the distances are extravagantly huge beyond the comprehension of our human minds. We cannot comprehend the size of the event horizon we are trapped in, not even the size of our own galaxy. Years ago, the same illiterate man conveyed to us this challenge. O company of jinn and mankind, if you are able to pass beyond the radiuses of the heavens and the earth, then pass. You will not pass except by authority. From God. The challenge sounded like this. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا معشر الجن والإنس إن استطعتم أن تنفذوا من أقطار السماوات والأرض فانفذوا لا تنفذون إلا بسلطان. For people living 1400 years ago, seeing only birds taking off the ground, it was quite a challenge. But even now, with all the development we achieved in science and space travel, the challenge didn't get any easier. In fact, we only got deeper knowledge of how hard the challenge really is. But wait a minute. This challenge didn't rule out passing through the universe limits. It left the door open, with an exception called authority, Sultan. How would this work? Has it ever been used? This will be the subject of our next talk. Thank you for watching and see you next episode.